Yeah, welcome back to Bitfumes. And in this episode, we are going to create our server on DigitalOcean. So you just have to log into Forge and then you have to click on Connect to DigitalOcean. But obviously, we don't have any account on DigitalOcean. So what we have to do, we have to create or simply sign up here. Okay, so I will sign up here. So I will say Bitfumes. webnologies@gmail.com, and don't ever email me on this email ID because I rarely open it. Okay, and then give the password, and now just click sign up, save password, and I will open Gmail in a new tab. I'm telling you that, you know, everything is set up by Forge, so you don't have to do anything. Just you have to give your API keys to your Forge, the DigitalOcean API keys, and that also accessed by the Forge easily. So it's asking, you can see after I registered, it's asking for authorization. So let's just give this authorization and authorize application. So you can see recent event, it's doing something on our server, and this is because we have not completed our DigitalOcean account. So if I open new tab and go to DigitalOcean once more, now again once more login, why it's logged out, I have just registered. So okay, so you can see we have not actually completed our account on DigitalOcean, so we have to add some of the payment system, and or we can say if we have a promo code, then that's okay. So I already have a promo code here, so let's just put that promo code here and let's apply, and this will give me $10 startup like thing so that I can start with here. Okay, so this is okay, but we obviously have to register here. So let's just give the payment card detail and then I will proceed. I have filled every detail for my card, so let's save this card so that payment option will successful. Now you can see payment method successfully added, and now our DigitalOcean account is successfully created. So let's just go here and let's just refresh this Forge. Then you will get this kind of option of creating server from DigitalOcean. And if you are not getting this option, please wait some time for DigitalOcean to complete its process. And I'm not sure why it's not coming here, but after I wait for 10 minutes, then it will come here. So just give it a try, that will surely come. So now click on DigitalOcean, and credential is personal, that's okay, and name is anything, and then we will get this least one just for demo purpose, and you can choose anyone from here. Okay, and now server region. So server region is very important because the server has to be closest to the targeted audience. So it doesn't matter where you are, and you just have to make sure the server you are choosing is closest to the targeted audience. So I'm from India, so I will choose Bangalore. Okay, then PHP 7.2 is great and everything looks good. Let's create server, and this will take at least 5 minutes, and these server credentials, you have to make sure this is super super important because this will not going to show you again. So let's just make a screenshot of this, so you have to make sure you will save these things somewhere else. Okay, so close this, and you can see it's super real time and status is building, it's now doing something, and it will take almost 5 minutes for me, and then you will see everything and every logs here. So let's just wait. So it's almost 2 minutes and still it's doing something, and you can see some of the events are already logged here. So again, wait for some time, and after even another 5 minutes, it's active and you can see the logs are lots of things is written here. So now what we have to do, we just have to go inside this server. So let's click here, and the IP address is also given here, and PHP version and connection is still unknown. And then you will land on this page. Here we can start from giving a new domain, but you can see the default site is given here. So if I go and copy this IP address, open new tab and go to this IP address, let's see what we are getting. We are getting PHP version and all the details on the server. So this means everything is looking quite nice, but we have to move everything inside this default. That means we have to create a Laravel project, then push that project on GitHub. Then via GitHub, we have to make sure we have that project on our default website, because we don't have any domain here and we will set up that domain later. So we will going to set up all these things in the next episode, but before, if you are going to register on DigitalOcean, please use the referral link given below, then you will get $10 startup money on your DigitalOcean account. That means you don't have to pay till $10 is exhausted. So if you have any doubt, feel free to message me, comment me, and don't forget to subscribe and like Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Till then, goodbye.